In the previous videos, you learned how to assign oxidation numbers and then how to write half reactions for our redox equations. In this video, we're going to look at how to balance each one of those half reactions. If you need help with oxidation numbers or writing half reactions, jump over to my website here and you'll find everything you need. So this video is all about balancing half reactions, but two things you should be aware of. One is we're an acidic medium. We'll be adding these H plus ions. We're an acidic medium. If you're in basic medium or acidic medium, you'll almost always be told. But it's the same process. We do the same thing with basic medium we do with acidic. We just add another step at the end. The other thing to note is we've been using oxidation numbers, but here we're actually going to look at ionic charge when we balance the half reactions. You could use oxidation numbers, but this is a little bit easier. Let's balance the half reactions for a simple redox equation. So here's the original equation, and I've written the oxidation numbers in. In this case, they're the same as the ionic charge. And here are the half reactions. We see that the iron is oxidized. This number gets bigger. And then the copper, it's reduced. This number gets smaller, goes from 2 to 0. So let's focus on balancing the half reactions. So the first step is we balance the atoms of interest. We have an iron here, a copper here, and a copper here. They're already balanced. Now we do the oxygen atoms, but there aren't any. Don't worry about it. Hydrogen, none here. It's a pretty simple one. But we do need to balance the electrons, the charge. So here we have a 0, neutral, and a 2 plus. Let's add 2 negative charges here, 2 electrons. Now everything over here is equal to 0. Everything here is 0. We're good. For the copper, we have the 2 plus here. We're going to need to add 2 electrons here. And now the charge is balanced. And we've balanced this half reaction. So these are pretty easy. Pause and give this one a try. So the atoms are balanced, no oxygens, no hydrogens, it's just the charge. So we have 0 here. Let's add 3 negative charges, and we do that by adding 3 electrons. It's balanced. Over here, we'll add 2 negative charges, 2 electrons, and that's balanced. And we've balanced these half reactions. So for simpler redox equations, it's not too bad. So when you're balancing these half reactions, it's the same thing every time, but be careful. Mistakes now can be costly later. Be sure to check your work to make sure the atoms and the charge are both balanced, and you'll be in good shape. Uh-oh, that escalated quickly. So here's the original equation, and these are the half reactions. So let's focus on balancing these half reactions. First, we balance the atoms of interest, manganese, manganese, sulfur, sulfur. In this case, they're already balanced. Then we balance the oxygen atoms by adding water. And we can add water because these reactions are aqueous. They're taking place in water. So I have 4 oxygens here and 2 here. So let's add 2 water molecules. Now we have 2 times the 1, that's 2, plus 2, 4 oxygens over here, 4 oxygens. Looking good. Now we need to balance the hydrogen atoms. And we're going to use H+. Remember, we're an acidic medium. And this is the hydrogen ion. That's what makes things acidic. So I have 2 times 2, 4 hydrogens here. We'll add 4 H plus ions. Now the hydrogens are balanced. The last part, we need to balance the charge. This is a little more difficult. I have 4 times 1 plus, 4 plus, and then I have 1 minus. That's for the whole thing here. So I have a total of 3 plus. That means I'm going to need to add 3 negative charges here for this to all balance out. And I'll do that by adding those electrons. So now the charge over here all adds up to 0. Over here, it's all 0. That's balanced. The atoms are the same. We've just balanced the half reaction. Now pause, see if you can do this one. Just follow the rules. The atoms are balanced. 4 oxygens and 3 oxygens. Add a water molecule. Now the oxygens are balanced, but we have 2 hydrogens. Add 2 hydrogen ions. Those are balanced. And balance the charge. 2 minus, 2 minus, and the 2 plus. So let's add 2 electrons here. Now everything on this side is equal to 2 minus. Everything on this side is 2 minus. We're done. We've balanced the half reactions. Let's try another one. So this is the original redox equation. We write the half reactions. Now we'll focus on balancing these half reactions. So pause and give this a try. So let's balance the atoms of interest first. Carbon, carbon, we're good. Two irons, let's put a 2 here. That's done. Oxygen atoms, we have 1 here and 2 here. We'll add 1 water molecule. So now we have 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 over here, we're good. 2 hydrogens, let's add 2 of our hydrogen ions, that H plus. And now let's do the electrons, the charge. Because we have 2 plus here, this is all neutral. So I'm going to add 2 negative charges, those 2 electrons. That's the balanced half reaction. Down here, 3 oxygen atoms, add 3 water molecules. Now the hydrogens, we have 6 hydrogens. Let's put 6 hydrogens over here. We have a 6 plus on this side and neutral on this side. Add 6 negative charges, 6 electrons. And this half reaction's balanced. Okay, this looks like fun. We have our complete redox equation. We can write the half reactions for it. And if you need help writing these half reactions or doing oxidation numbers, just jump over to my website there. You'll get what you need. So pause and balance these half reactions. So the atoms, manganese, manganese, that's good. 2 carbons, 2 carbons. The atoms are balanced. The oxygens, looks like we have 4 oxygens. Let's add 4 water molecules. And for the hydrogen ions, we have 4 times 2, 8 there. So let's add 8 hydrogen ions over here to balance those. And the charge is a little bit of work here. We have 8 times 1 plus. So we have 8 plus, and then this whole ion has a charge of 1 minus. So we have 1 minus. 7 plus on this side. Over here, it's just the 2 plus. So if I add 5 negative charges here, I would get 2 plus. We'd be all good. Let's add 5 electrons, and we've balanced this half reaction. Down here, we have 1 oxygen and 2. So let's add a water molecule over here. For the hydrogens, now we have 2 plus 5, that's 7 plus 1. We have 8 here and 4 here. So we need 4 more hydrogen atoms. So we'll add those H plus, 4 of those. And then for the charge, you can see this is neutral over here. We have 4 plus. So to balance the charge, we'll add 4 negative charges, 4 electrons. And we're done. We've balanced the half reactions. You can always check your work to make sure you have the same number of atoms on each side, and the charge is the same on each side. So now you can balance half reactions. Next up, we're going to combine the half reactions, make sure the electrons match, and we'll have our final balanced redox reaction. If you need more help, head over to my website, and you can also find information there on how you can support my work. This is Dr. B, and thanks for watching.